I've learned to slam on the brake.
Hi everyone, Miss Lenk here. Welcome to your virtual house assembly. Me and the other house leaders have put this together for you to make sure you're doing okay at home and to give you a few tips if you are struggling a little bit. We're really missing you at school, missing being in lessons with you, missing assemblies, believe it or not. But in the meantime, we hope that some of our top tips can help you out. We really appreciate the brilliant work you're sending into school. It's really, really nice to receive and know all your class teachers are loving receiving all the work you're sending. It's brilliant. Absolutely loving all the entries for your Whitcliffe challenge, seeing all the miles that you're walking, that you're cycling, that you're running. Absolutely fantastic contributing to your houses, which is great. And just your general updates of how you're choosing to spend your time at home in these really strange times. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit first about looking after yourself and well-being. So these are just a few of my top five tips if I'm feeling a bit down in the dumps, not feeling very positive about the day ahead, and you can take what you want away from it. So you know, you can do it as much or as little as you like. It's really important that in these crazy times you are being kind to yourself and you're being patient with yourself, okay? There is going to be days where you are struggling and that's fine, okay? Hopefully, some of these five top tips that I'm going to give you will help you out with those. So, tip number one, wake up reasonably early and make yourself a to-do list. I always feel better after I've made myself a list, okay? This can be as big or as little as you want. I tend to include breaks and lunches in my to-do list, and it feels really good to tick off what you've achieved that day. It could be going for a walk, tick that off your list. It could be doing some English work. It could be doing a bit of drama work. It could be doing a bit of music, maths, whatever it is. Make your to-do list and stick to that order, okay? Tip number two, be positive and grateful for the things you have. I tend to think of it in this structure. I am, I can, and I have. And just think about what those things that you have and that you can do and that you are, okay? So have a think about that. Number three, stay active, okay? Fresh air clears your head, okay? I don't mean go for a 10K run, okay? If you want to do that, grill. Running's definitely not my thing, okay? But a walk, even if it's just around the block, just clears your head. So if you're struggling, if you're feeling a bit claustrophobic in your four walls in your house, get out for a walk, get out in the fresh air, come back to that to-do list and think, right, what am I going to achieve next? Tip number four, connect with friends. Connect with friends, connect with family. It's really important you stay connected and you stay talking to the people around you, okay? That could be via social media, it could be video calling, it could be just ringing up, it could be texting, it could even be by post, whatever you fancy. Some of my friends have wrote to me that live further away. That's been really nice during lockdown. But I know Miss Johnson is going to talk to you about staying connected, so watch this space for her little video. And tip number five, learn something new every single day. So I've been trying to keep this to a weekday, but if you just try and learn a new skill, a new fact, it doesn't have to be something massive. It could be learning how to cook, learning how to bake, learning new facts that you don't know, learning a bit of another language, but it's really fulfilling, and you can check that off your to-do list, and it makes you feel good knowing that you've learned something new that day. So learning new skill is tip number five. At the moment, we don't know how things are going to unfold or come into fruition. We don't have to, okay? The important thing is that you are keeping motivated and you are keeping positive, okay? Believe in yourselves. You can overcome and achieve much more than you think you can, okay? So if you need to take a pause and reflect and reevaluate how you are spending your days, that's absolutely fine. But don't settle for anything less than what you want, okay? You're all fantastic. We all miss you loads. We can't wait to be back in the classroom with you all. Keep doing what you're doing. And remember, if you need to pause and reevaluate, then do that, okay? So they're my top 5 tips, staying positive and having a bit of structure to your day. I hope that helps. And I'm going to pass you on to the next house leader. I'll see you all really soon.
I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone.
Hey everyone, hope you're alright. I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about some skills and how to learn some new ones. So, my personal skills, the first one that I ever really developed, besides obviously speaking, is music. So I've got a trombone on my wall, got a guitar that's electric, and a semi-acoustic electric guitar over there, and this is a mixture of two skills. My first one, playing music. The second one, some DIY. I've recently bought a house and I've learned how to do some little bits of DIY, like building massive cabinets and making them look cool, so they're like little levitating, like with lightsabers and bling. And one of my nerdiest skills is my love for little twisty puzzles. My record for a Rubik's Cube is about 26 seconds. And the way that I've developed all of these skills is by practice. So the main thing that you can do to get better at something is keep trying over and over again. You can watch videos, you can look up some instructions to help you out, but the main thing is keep trying and never stop until you've accomplished what you want. Hope you're all well, and I'll see you.
Morning guys, hope you're all safe and well. Now in this lockdown period, it's important that you're keeping fit, keep your mind, your body healthy. So I'm just about to go now for a 5 kilometre run. That'll go towards a great Whitcliffe challenge that we're all getting involved with. So that's my lunch run completed. Did 5.6 kilometres in 30 minutes. No personal records there, but it's not what I'm all about. I like to get there on the open road, feel the wind in my hair, just enjoy myself. Hi guys, so today I'm in school. I'm going to put a few shots up.
Morning guys, hope you're all safe and well. Today I'm going to mix it up a bit. I'm going to be doing a duo wicks. Outside weather's not great, so that's bright up now, but I'm going to do something a bit different today.
Push it to the limit.
So that's my duo wicks done for the morning. I'm just going to go over a few reasons why it's important that you keep your fitness. As well as healthy eating, it's good to maintain a regular exercise routine. Reasons why: it improves your sleep, helps you sleep longer, helps you go to bed earlier. It releases chemicals that improve mental health, your mood, and help you deal with stress and reduce your risk of depression. It helps you control your weight, helps your body to manage your blood sugar and insulin levels, and helps reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes, which is on the rise in children. I'm going to give you 5 top tips now, Mr. E's 5 top tips now, Mr. E's 5 top tips to make exercise a part of your regular routine. So, number 1, make everyday activities more active. Maybe if you were to get on public transport to go to school, when we're back at school, maybe you could walk, cycle your bike. Number 2, work out with family and friends. Have a workout partner. Plan social activities that involve exercise. Maybe instead of playing on a console, you go down to the park, play football. Number 3, keep a log of all your exercise and activities using a fitness tracker such as Strava. Number 3, keep a log of all your activities using a fitness tracker such as Strava. This might help you set some goals and stay motivated. Number 4, try to make exercise fun. Mix things up a bit. I've been doing a bit of jogging, a bit of cycling, duo wicks. The other day when it was my day up at school in the rota, I did half an hour of basketball. Number 5, find activities to do even when the weather is bad. Today I've stayed in, I've done a duo wicks. Maybe you could run up and down the stairs. Things like that. Today I've stayed in and I've done a duo wicks. There's plenty more different activities, different people you can watch on YouTube. Okay, those are Mr. Reed's 5 top tips. Now, I hope you're all staying safe, looking after yourselves, and I'm missing you loads and loads and loads. So I'll see you all soon.
Hi everyone, it's Miss Gregory. I'm going to speak to you quickly about something you'll have heard a lot about at Whitcliffe, and that's resilience. Resilience means not giving up at something and keeping going. That might seem a little bit hard at the moment because nothing's normal. You might be finding it quite hard to get yourself up out of bed in the morning, to have a routine, get into your home learning, do some exercise, and stay connected with friends and family who you aren't seeing. So what can we do about that to keep ourselves motivated in these weird times? One thing you can do is a bit of exercise. Exercise isn't just good for your body, it also is good for your mind because it releases endorphins, which create a positive feeling in your body and will help you feel a little bit better. So at the moment we're running the Great Whitcliffe Challenge, a house competition to travel from John O'Groats in Scotland to Land's End in Cornwall. Houses are competing, staff are joining in to get kilometres for their house, and that's a really good way to set yourself a bit of a challenge to keep your body going and your mind. Dr. Fairley set himself a personal challenge within the Great Whitcliffe Challenge. He wanted to see if he could run 10 kilometres a day for 10 days. Now a 10 kilometre run isn't easy. After the first day or a couple of days, his body might have been aching, might have wanted to give up, might have thought, I've not told anyone I'm doing this, so no one knows if I've given up. He had a fall on one of his runs, but as the old saying goes, he got up and he carried on, and he completed 100 kilometres over 10 days. That's no easy feat and shows great Whitcliffe resilience, so well done Dr. Fairley. And hopefully we can all take a little leap out of that, but even if you do 1 kilometre a day, that's great, and it will help your body feel better and therefore your mind, because it's really important to look after our mental health at the moment. Set yourself manageable tasks. Don't think, I'm going to sit down and do 8 hours schoolwork today. Chances are you're probably going to get a little bit bored, it might be hard to keep yourself motivated. So break tasks down into small chunks that are manageable, and once you've done a task, you'll feel better because you've carried it through and completed it. I remember an assembly we had at school, watching a video where the first thing to do in the morning was to make your bed. Because as soon as you've done that, you've already achieved one task. You've already set yourself up for a good day. So let's do those little tasks that we can do. Keep doing your home learning. If you're stuck, contact a teacher, because we're all here still, all ready to help, and we can't wait to see you when you're back. Bye, take care. Where did you come from, lady? Hi everyone, I hope that you're all okay and you're all staying well. I know that we're all going through a little bit of an uncertain time at the minute, and you may be feeling a whole range of emotions, okay? I know over the last few weeks I've felt quite bored, I felt lost and frustrated at times and not really knowing where to place myself, and other days I felt absolutely fine, I felt really positive, I've gone out, conquered my day and had the best day ever. Okay, we're all going to respond to this differently, and that is absolutely fine. As long as we know how to keep ourselves positive, how to keep active, and how to keep connected with others, that is what's important. With that being said, I personally found that staying connected with those closest around me has really helped me during this time, and has given me that little bit of normality that I've needed. So I'm going to give you a few tips and a little bit of info on staying connected with your friends and your family, staying connected with yourself, and staying connected with school, okay? Staying connected with friends and family. I personally think it's really important to maintain healthy relationships with those closest to you. So that may be your best friend, it may be someone in your household, just someone who you can go and talk to if you've got any worries, or if you literally just need a chat, okay? If you just need a little chat to pick you up, that's really important. It's really important for your well-being as well. So something as simple as a phone call, a text message, a WhatsApp message, or a FaceTime, just something keep you connected with that other person or those other people, okay? Social media is also a really good way of connecting. I am really, really nosy. I love going on Facebook and seeing what my family's done on the day, okay? Social media is a really good way to connect with others and see what other people have been doing. Be creative. There's a lot of platforms at the minute where you can be creative. So you've got Zoom, you have got FaceTime, you have got WhatsApp call. There's a lot of platforms now where you can be creative and do quizzes. You can do
virtual cup of teas if you want to. You can watch movies together if you want to. Okay, all in a virtual world. I've been doing a week of quiz, and that has really, really given me something to look forward to at the end of every week. You know, I can see my friends, we can have a laugh, okay, and just do a little quiz every week. Connect with old friends. A lot of us have got a lot of extra time right now, and it could be a good time for you to connect with those who you've not really spoken to in a while, or you've not really had time to because you've had other commitments. Connect with those old friends and connect with those people who you really want to, okay? Also, you don't need to use any social media, okay? You can have a games night at home with those in your household. You can have a movie night. You can just sit and have a chat around the dinner table if you want to, just so you can stay connected with those who are around you. Also, what I have done is I have written a little card, like a little postcard to my closest friends, okay? And it just basically says, thinking about you, hope you're all okay, can't wait for this to blow over and we can finally reunite and have a really good girly chat, okay? So that is also always appreciated, I think, okay? It's really nice to receive something that is sometimes handmade because, you know, time and effort has gone into it. And you can also just safely post that through their letterbox or give it to the postman if you want to. Staying connected with yourself. Sometimes you need to do what you feel is good for you, okay? So if you want to take a social media break, for instance, that's really good because I know I can find myself scrolling a little bit too much and I have to say to myself, put your phone down now, pick up a book or do something different, okay? Read a book, you can go to the park, go on a walk, go on a run if that's what you want to do, or a bike ride. Do things that you enjoy, okay? Even if you just literally want to sit down and relax for an hour, that is absolutely okay, okay? Sometimes take a break away from the screen, whether that is through scrolling, whether that is schoolwork. Your mind and your body does need a little break away from the screen, okay? And last but not least, staying connected with school. Although school is partially closed, we are still here for each and every single one of you, okay? Send an email for any help that you need, whether that is your form tutor, a trusted member of staff, someone who you get on with, just send that email, okay? Don't be afraid if you need help. Give your best shot at work, okay? We've got a lot of work on SharePoint. Give your best shot at that. Try keep to the deadlines. Keep yourself in a little bit of routine because that will give you that little bit of normality as well, okay? And also, check on the school social media. We are always posting stuff about things that's happened in school, what's been going on, and also upcoming challenges like the Whitcliffe event, okay? So keep up to date with that. That will keep you connected with us and what we're doing and what we've got planned, okay? It's really important that you have those around you right now, that's someone who you feel like you can talk to, okay? And I hope to see you all very soon, and hope we will be connected in school. See you later.